Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how you can get a free SSL certificate with AWS Certificate Manager. But before we get into that, let's take a quick look at what SSL TLS exactly is. Now, SSL is a technology that is responsible for the green lock in the address field of your browser. You've probably seen this before on many e-commerce websites. And this lock basically means that your web browser has assured the identity of the server that you're talking with, and that all data to that website or to that server is encrypted. So why would you use AWS Certificate Manager? Well, first of all, it's free. Secondly, it automatically renews your certificate as they are going to expire. And it's fully integrated with AWS services, so you can generate a certificate and immediately link it up to a CloudFront distribution. So what's next in this tutorial? Well, first of all, I'm gonna request a certificate for my own domain name. Then we're going to validate that request by email. And then finally, we're going to enable the SSL certificate for my CloudFront distribution. So without further ado, let's begin. So to start, I'm going to go to the AWS console. And I'm going to scroll down here to the Security and Identity section. And here I'm going to click on the Certificate Manager to open its console. And right away, I'm shown a splash page which explains what the Certificate Manager exactly is. So I'm going to click Get Started, and it automatically starts by requesting a new certificate. So in my case, I want a certificate for my domain name, sevg.be, and I also want a wildcard certificate for all the subdomain names of my website. So I want one for sevg.be, but also for www.sevg.be or anagram.sevg.be or whatever. So I'm going to type star dot and then my domain name to get a wildcard certificate. So now I'm going to click on review and request, and I'm going to confirm this request. Now, of course, Amazon has to verify that I'm the owner of this domain name, because I can't request certificates for domain names that aren't mine. So to do this, Amazon is going to send a series of emails to all these addresses to confirm your ownership of this domain name. So this is the email that Amazon sent me to verify that I'm the owner of this domain name. And it basically asks me, hey, if you are the owner and you want to approve this request for a certificate, please click on this link. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. So this opens up an overview page in which Amazon asks you again to verify the information that they have on you. So I agree on this, so I click I approve. And there you have it, success. The certificate for my domain name has successfully been approved. So if I go back to the AWS management console and I go to the certificate manager, I see that I have one certificate here for my domain name and the status is issued. It's currently not in use though, so let's go and fix that. So let's go to services here. And I'm going to link the certificate up with my CloudFront distribution. And this is remarkably easy. So I'm going to click on the CloudFront icon. And I'm going to go to sevg.be. And I'm going to click Edit. And here I can basically select which certificate I want to attach to my distribution. So I want to attach our newly generated certificate. So I'm going to click Custom SSL Certificate. And I've already uploaded a certificate here in the past, but that one has expired. So I'm going to click on this drop-down menu, and here is my newly created certificate. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to scroll down to the bottom, and I'm going to click Yes, Edit. And now Amazon is going to roll out this change throughout their CDN, and in a matter of minutes, my HTTPS certificate or my SSL certificate will be live for anyone to use. So I waited a couple of minutes, and now I want to know if the SSL certificate is indeed live. So to test this, I'm going to go to https://sevg.be, and you'll now notice that there is a lock icon here in the address field telling me that the communication to this server is indeed encrypted and secure. So if I click on it, Safari tells me that it's using an encrypted connection to my web server. And I can even verify that that certificate has been signed by Amazon. So that's it for this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching.